I've never told myself that I made it. I think there is always more that you can do.
Blanca Trevino. As the president and CEO of Mexico-based IT company Softtek, she's helping to pave the way for Latin America's entry into the world of information technology.
When you think about Mexico, people think about Cancun, about tequila. They never saw Mexico as an important player in the IT industry.
Blanca co-founded Softtek in 1982, at a time when few women were in the technology field, and even fewer were starting their own companies.
When we started, like any other entrepreneur, we had those huge dreams of the kind of things that we wanted to achieve. I wouldn't say it was gender would make a difference at that time. It was more the opportunity of starting a new company, starting a new adventure. And that it felt, it has been a privilege, I have to say.
Blanca became CEO in 2000 and now manages a staff of nearly 9,000 and oversees 30 offices worldwide.
Softtek pretty much pioneered the term nearshoring. What exactly is nearshoring?
It's not pretty much pioneering. We are. It's a trademark. When we look at the U.S. and we said it's the most important market, the market that has that's this huge demand for IT services, India was and is the leader, but at the end of the day, distant location, right? There is something we can do. We can offer services from Mexico to the U.S., but there's all those advantages of doing it close, near. That's why it's near shore. It's proximity. By being in the same time zone, you are able to compete, even from a cost perspective, very effectively.
Named as a rising star on Fortune's list of 50 most powerful women, and as one of Forbes' 50 most powerful women in Mexico, Blanca sees an advantage in being a woman in leadership.
Do you think female CEOs lead different than male CEOs, and how so?
We do. The difference between men and women is how we define success in some cases, right? For men, being successful, it's probably related to the fortune they made. But for women, I believe, success is more about, am I really being a positive influence in our team? Am I being able to change or transform if it's needed.
Before launching Softtek, Blanca studied computer science in her home city of Monterrey, Mexico.
How did it happen for you with your family, with your father, when you were studying computer science, a leading woman on a tech company in the 1980s?
My dad always supported me. When I grew up, it was more about the things that you could do, not the things that you couldn't do. But being very honest, my mom has been also incredible because she decided to get into university when he had 6 kids. I remember telling him, so, I don't know, when I was gonna have my first daughter, I said, do you think I should retire? Why? No, you can do it. Do you need us to help you in any way?
So you are a CEO, a mother of 2, and a grandmother. How do you find balance between your corporate life and your family life?
It's always to have your priorities very clear. I never stopped working. As a matter of fact, I started my family almost at the same time that we started Softtek. So it was like they grew together. For me, it's difficult to separate one from the other. But what was important, it's I enjoy all the roles that I play.
As the woman at the helm of one of Latin America's leading tech companies, Blanca has plenty of advice for others looking to fill the CEO seat.
Give yourself a chance. Don't start looking at something that will be like self-fulfilling prophecies that this is not going to happen. Give yourself your opportunity. Think about the things that you can achieve. In that company, there is no open policies for a woman to work. Look for the other company. You don't find any company, start your own company. If you have that self-esteem, when you unleash the strengths that you have, when you unleash the vision or the one of things you're going to achieve, no one's going to stop you.